fandom, a treacherous frontier. These are the voyages of the channel Downsizeit. Its continuing mission, to explore strange new genres, to seek out new games and new player communities, to boldly go where no nerd has gone before.
Greetings, my name is Ben, aka Downsizeit, and we are back to me releasing Worlds coverage, and my final three videos are going to be the three games I played during the Teams tournament on Sunday. Fortunately, Steve Smaha, who's from Chicago and has come down to the Ozark Mountain Open the past few years, had an opening on his team and offered to let me take up that slot, which was very generous of him. And our team consisted of him, me, Angry Ewok, of all things, and then a gentleman from Poland, which I apologize, can't remember your name, but a gentleman from Poland. And with the teams tournament, the rules were each faction had to be represented, so we had to have at least one fleet. Three of the four factions had to be represented, and we can only have one duplicate faction. So we had one Separatist, which was Steve's, Angry Ewok, I believe he had Rebels, and then we had two Imperial, the Polish gentleman and myself had Imperial fleets. I basically just used my same fleet, because I didn't bring any extra stuff. And the rule was, if you duplicated factions, you could not duplicate unique, across the entire team, you cannot duplicate uniques. It's like you can't have multiple Hondos. And unfortunately, both myself and the Polish gentleman had Price, and he really did not want to give up Price. So I had to give up Price. So I had to make some slight modifications to my list. Fortunately, Steve had, since he lived there, he was able to bring a bunch of cards and stuff. And so I took Price off of my Kuat and replaced her with Palpatine. And then swapped out heavy ion emplacements for leading shots. Essentially because there really wasn't any point trying to do the gimmick again without Price to help guarantee it with the double crit. Oh, and then also gunnery teams for fire control teams. Again, because I wasn't going to try to do the gimmick. So a more basic Kuat build. Just kind of like a last minute change. Space. I had about less than 10 minutes to make the change. That's Sunday morning. So, but anyway, this was one where, you then take the scores that we each did on each of our battles, put them together, and that's our team score. Unfortunately, we didn't do very well as a team, mainly because of Steve. I don't think Steve minds me saying this. Steve and I didn't do very well for our team. Angry Ewok and our, and the gentleman from Poland, they actually did pretty well, but because Steve and I did so poorly, kind of balanced out. But I actually don't even know how we ended up, how we finished as far as the team is concerned overall. But I do have my videos of my games. So, and this will be the first one. And also, just want to make it clear on these. I forgot to ask my opponents for their lists. So I apologize for that. So I don't know their specific lists. My previous games, I could pull from T4. That's what I did for those. But the team's tournament wasn't put on T4, so in the list weren't ever officially recorded. So I'll try to do the best from memory for these games to let you guys know what they brought, but the specifics, unfortunately, I won't be able to give a lot of detail. So my first game was against Jakob Lausen, He was bringing a cursed agate list with an MC-75 agate list. And this one, pretty brutal list I discovered. And not discovered, I kind of knew it was going to happen and I didn't plan accordingly with the combo he was about to lay down. And I'll just let that combo lay down. He did happen. I'm not going to spoil it. I'll let you guys see what happened to me. but anyway, I will say this. MC-75s with Kyrsta are almost more tanky than a Starhawk with Kyrsta. It was... that thing was a beast. But, again, I apologize for not having his list to share with you guys. But hope you enjoy the battle. And this one, you know, this was Sunday after our already long week of Disney in Orlando and then coming into the tournament. So I was just going into these teams' games just to play casually and just have fun. But still wanted to do well. But definitely a more casual bend for my own mindset. Just guys can know where my mindset was. So, coming up next is my battle with Jakob. And then after the battle, we'll kind of talk about how it went. All right. So, got... this will be my playing teams. First game... what was your name again?
Jakob.
And where are you from, Jakob?
Denmark.
Very nice. All right. And you've got an agate list. And he chose to be first player, so it chose my volatile deposits. No, we don't need this. We need... very interesting setup for this new... type of teams game. I like it. All right. All right. First obstacle. A little barrier here so I can get an idea. All right, so we will do asteroid there. What's your last name, Jakob?
Lausen.
Lausen?
Yeah.
Okay. Right. Lausen, okay. Cool. Nice. Very nice. Okay. We'll go ahead and that one right there. I'm gonna do okay. Dust cloud. Like so. Okay, and then we'll just put a refill about right there. All right.
And I had made some variations to my fleet. Had to get rid of Price, because one of my teammates said Price. Yeah, so I had to swap out for it. So I decided to swap out for Palpatine and then did some other changes just to make it work better. So I'm not doing my double crit gimmick. So I have gunnery teams instead now. Leading shots. Oh, I guess I shouldn't have taken that up. Oh well. Comsnet. Okay. Alright, we're going to do the Chimera at speed 1.
Can you just move this?
So when moving obstacles, it has to be towards the rift. It has to move at least 1, but less than 2.
Alright. So now,
Let's say it's here.
To
at least there, but at most there, and then you can rotate it in any direction. So like for here, you could do this. Now, if there's a ship in the way, like let's say there's a ship.
Comsnet Gazanti, speed 1.
Actually, get all the way to the 1. You only have to go for the ship itself. Yeah, I think it's a temporary.
Yeah, temporary.
Okay, and is that the intensify or the
shields to max?
Shields to max, okay.
No, sorry, intensify.
Intensify, okay. And I would recommend not landing on the rift. Although that's actually, yeah, with Oslo, it's you're not completely screwed over if that happens.
Yeah.
Because I'm not picking the price.
I have not had anyone pick advanced gunner.
Speed 2, alright. Okay, then my Kuat, formerly Governor Price's ship, now Palpatine's ship. Speed 1. Let's see, I don't want to change anything. I think I'm good there.
I think because it can't move the 1.
Very nice. Very good.
One on the front, six to the side.
Boarding troopers, nice.
6 on the other side and 0 on the rear.
7s, the warning system. Okay. Very good. Alright, and you have, looks like you have 5 ships. Well, I'll get a pass token.
So it says it must move at least distance 1, but it can be moved up to 2. Unless it's interrupted.
So I don't think it matters whether or not you're on it or not.
Speed 3, alright.
So we alternate moving obstacles.
Okay.
And this is where, depending on what you want to do, you can make it do one of 2 things.
Alright, I think I am good on my dials.
Yep. Right. And I'm set.
Alright, and FYI, good luck. Yes, good luck. These dials, by the way, are my Thrawn dials, and these are going to be the ship dials for the ship. Yeah. So no Thrawn dials, no fleet commands for me to start.
I'll let you send it.
Very good.
And I will activate Hondo Contemplate first.
Okay.
Reveal a squadron, take it as a token. Send it to the MC-75.
That's why Bale could be good.
And this is one of the obstacles, whereas first player, you get to place first.
Yeah, but this station is your anyway. Yours.
Okay, we'll go with my comms net as well. Concentrate fire, take a token, sending it over to the Chimera. And we'll go forward, speed 1.
Dealt with number 2, Session Engineering, he's going to pass 2 shields. And recover 1. So he's 1 down in the rear.
Hey, we'll do parts resupply. It's navigate. Taking a token, and then we'll be parts resupplying the 2 Star Destroyers. And forward speed 1. Okay.
Alright, we'll do the second filter. Reveals an engineering. It's going to send 2 shields. Recover 1.
That's a very interesting gimmick to actually get higher shields.
Yeah.
And getting by the aspirant thing where you can't raise because you're just sending them. You're not raising. Never thought of that idea. Makes for a very tanky MC-75. Alright, we'll do Thrawn. To navigate, I'm going to use it as the dial. We're going to speed up to speed 2. And we're going to get an extra click at the 2, like so.
Cartridge supply. Navigate, he's going to take that as a token. And do cartridge supply. Because I went up against the slow one. This lasted until. One to each pelt and one to the flagship.
Okay, let's see, Kuwat. Alright, Kuwat's going to be in navigate, and I'm going to drop to speed 0.
Flagship. He has a navigate. I will use that. He has a dial.
Okay.
And go to speed 3.
Alright.
And squadrons.
Yes. Alright, and I think, end of round, we'll refresh, you'll...
Navigate token to refresh pottery supply.
And I will be doing the same as well, and you'll get one victory token, and I'll get two.
Okay.
Alright, no Thrawn dials, no fleet commands.
The same for me. I will use the Comsnet flotilla. He has a ground fire. I'll send it to the intensified fireballs.
How's it going, Fox?
Yes. Alright, I'll be doing my comms net. It's going to be a navigate. I'm going to take it as a token. And I'm going to pass it over Chimera. And then go on speed 1. Here comes Ezra. You leave that asteroid alone. I know what you're going to do with that. I'll go ahead and pass.
Yeah. guy, number two. He's got an engineering. He's got a pass one shield and a cover one.
This guy left. He has a con fire. Somewhere where you can make that help, you can only consider it a life session. I have medium stuff.
Speed 2.
Coordinate?
Yep. Nothing else? Let's just brace it.
Oh, yeah.
Alright. You'll do parts resupply to navigate, dropping to zero. We're clear. Nice. Okay. Let's go with my Kuat. Let's navigate. Use it as the dial. Should be good. Alright, we're gonna get an extra click at the one here. And hopefully not hit my own guy. Alright. Like so.
I will do my last pelt up. and engineering. Just gonna send one shield and recover one.
Thrawn, navigate. Use it as the dial. It's already got the token. Yeah, we'll just slow down to one. Do this little turn like so. Alright.
Again, our squadron phase.
Yes, squadron phase. Okay. All right, refresh phase. We'll each just get one because you're contesting this now. So I get one and you get one. And on to round three. All right, I will be using Chimera to switch to intensify firepower. I will activate it.
Do mine first, just...
Yep.
I'll do shields to max, and I'll do intensify fire.
Very good. And then revealing a Thrawn dial, concentrate fire.
Yep.
All right. Well, now things about to get interesting.
Stuff is about to get hit.
Yes. Oh, yes.
I am going to start with my comms net flotilla.
Okay.
Concentrate fire. Send the token to the filter.
Very good.
And keep doing his thing.
Okay, I'll do a parts resupply. It's a navigate, taking a token and staying at speed zero.
I will do my Estra, and I reveal some nav. You can use it as a dial, but I will do part resupply, and send a token to that guy. And I'll Estra, of course. Gotta do that.
Yep, Ezra.
Gotta do that first.
Very nice. Alright, we're going to do comms net. It's concentrate fire. I'm going to take a token with that one. Pass it over to the Chimera. Don't take some shots.
Yep.
I will.
We'll see what happens.
Am I at medium range of this guy? Not quite. So I'll do front to front.
Yep.
Or not front, I mean front to side. Yep. Kind of futile, but we'll just... And I will intensify.
Two?
Yep.
I will take two.
I know you're just going to heal it back up, but... And then I'll flak out the side.
Yep.
Just for you to do the scatter. So Tycho for one.
He'll take one.
And Shara for nothing.
You can join.
Oh, yep. Yes.
Easier.
And then movement. No, like so.
Yep. This guy. He has engineering. I'll take one shield to max. And then I won't do anything with the dial.
I'm crossing a line, but I just want to double check.
We're gonna go with the MC.
Okay, I think I've got a clear shot on you to the side. Alright, we'll go with Thrawn. That is medium range, right?
Yep.
Alright, so navigate. I'll use the dial. Plus the Thrawn Confire dial. And we will start with a front to side into Kyrsta. The five reds, four blues with spinal. Okay. I will, you have two braces, right?
Yep.
I'll intel one of them. Then we will confire in a blue.
Make it a little quicker.
That's not what I was hoping for, but it's okay. Then we will intensify.
So what are the two?
Yeah, let's see, 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12 damage.
So I will brace it down. What did you say, 12?
12.
So I'll brace it down to 6. And just take them on the
side. Take it all on the shields. Alright, then we will gunnery teams. I believe that's going to be obstructed. Yep, so 4 reds to your other Pelta. And we'll intensify that for 3.
I'll evade the crit. That's great. Yep, we'll raise it down to 1.
Sounds good. All right, now movement.
He's going to use it as a dial.
Literally, so he's got to move the and he's just going to set what's grand and take a damage card until my health heals.
This one, I'll be
Okay. I'm not going to use the dial. I'm just going to go straight one.
There goes the
Y-Wing.
Okay, so we're
arcing
a Y-Wing down so far.
Oh, okay. I think I stayed out of the double arc.
Okay. That's an engineering. I'll take one shield with shields to max. I'm going to take legs put two to the side and recover one.
This is the maneuver I'm
going to
do.
I'll do two rounds to the front
of the ISD.
Okay. And intensify.
For one, I'll go ahead and redirect to my port side.
Engineering token to a navigate.
Nice.
And drop a speed.
Very nice. Go Ahsoka. Okay. Well, unfortunately, you didn't shoot me yet. So, cool. It's an engineering. Already got the token. Don't need to heal anything yet, so we'll just take some shots. Alright, yeah, I gotta clear to your side there, so we'll start with that. So, we've got three reds, two blues, three blacks. Okay. Do you have PDICs or anything like
no.
that? Okay. I think I will go into leading shots that one. No, first I'm going to Confire. Confire in a red. Confire in a blue. Nope. Alright, so we will leading shots this. Let's reroll these. That's what I was looking for. All right, we will stop your green brace.
Yeah.
That'll be 2, 4, 6, 8, 9. And then I will be, even though I don't, I'll just declare it now, doing assault concussions. Yes.
So 9.
Yeah, this week going to be a lot of video editing this coming week. Yep. Okay.
And I'll just take it as it is.
Yep, so then assault concussions first. Yep, yep. And then 5.
I will do a redirect.
Do a redirect? Yep, yep, no, that's cool.
I'll redirect to the rear.
Okay.
So 2 to the rear.
And 3 on the side. Very nice. So you threw away your exhausted brace, I'm guessing. Yep. And you have Waylex, though. Yeah, so that's such a tank. This thing's a tank. For my gunnery teams, is it worth throwing here? It's not. I will flak out the front.
Yep.
So, Tycho, for one.
Tycho scatters.
Okay. Shara, for two. All right. All right, and then moving. Pretty sure I'm going to ram my Gazanti here.
Yep.
So I ram my Comsnet Gazanti, and there we go.
I will activate the MT-75.
Mm-hmm.
I will use boarding troopers on the Kuat.
Okay.
Tapping everything but contain.
Okay.
I will take one shield, which gives to max. I will spend my dial and my token. A couple free shields. 1, 2, 3. Oil lick the brace. Back. I will shoot out the front into the front of the tour.
Okay.
Spending a contain.
Three blue to black. I mean, you could do back to back as long as it's the same reference point.
I will use external rex.
Nice.
I will use intensified firepower.
Yep.
Yep. And leave as is. So I will not spend the accuracy.
Okay, best W7s?
Yep.
Very nice.
And XI7s.
And XI7s. Nice. 2, 4, 6, 8, 9 damage.
I might as well get my salvo back.
Well, that's going to be the biggest one you get. So, yep, might as well throw the brace now.
Brace 5.
And I will redirect.
Yep.
Boarding troopers is sucks. Alright, we'll send 1 and then 4 off the front.
I will do my side to your front.
Okay.
Using a contain again. I will use intensified firepower. And I will lock your contain.
Lock my contain.
And do 4.
And do 4. Okay, well, I will ECM to contain. And XI7s, it's not going to really matter for later turns, so I'm just going to do 1 and 3 face down.
Fly straight ahead.
Okay.
I think. Just gonna pull this off. Just move her away a little bit.
Would you like me to mark this?
I think I'm gonna try this.
Okay.
So I'm not gonna fit on the...
Not gonna fit on the 2. And we'll basically see where the 1's gonna be. Not gonna fit there. So let me see if you're gonna hit my Kuat at this distance. Yep. So you'll hit the Kuat, so the Kuat will take the damage. Because he's the closest. And take 1. Alright, squad phase.
Tiger will spend the brace. Attack the front of the court. 1.
Gotta take it.
Shower will do the same. 4-1.
Man.
That was the round.
It is. Alright, you'll get 2 victory tokens. I'll get 1. Alright, we've got intel refresh, assault concussion refresh. Oh, I think I'm going to be dead. Yeah, we'll go and refresh ECM, just in case. All right, and let's see,
I will do intensify, I will do shields to max.
And I will also do intensify, and then another Thrawn dial, concentrate fire.
I will activate, I'll just give him a dial. I will activate the 75, he has an engineering. I will take one shield to max. And discard the damage card.
Okay.
Alright. I'm gonna go with the MG-30.
I will shoot out my front. I'll shoot out my side. We'll use it first.
Side, okay.
Defending it with
okay.
How much does he have left?
Not much. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 5 left.
I will intensify.
Ugh. God, just what you needed. Point defense failure. 3, 4, and 5. Very good.
And let's try and open up that ISD. It's going to do front to front. I will lock the brace and do 5.
Lock the brace, do 5. Okay, I'll go in ECM. Brace to 3. Redirect 1 from XI 7s. 1 and 1, 2. Hit the Gazanti. Yep. Yep, staying in place. Very good. So this Gazanti takes the damage. Alright. Speaking of that Gazanti, we'll do that Gazanti. Comms net. Concentrate fire. I'm going to use that one to take a token. Pass it over to the Chimera. And then I'll take 2 shots into the side of your guy there.
Yep.
Start with the front. Concentrate fire. I will lock down your redirect. Take 1. And then side shot. Take 1. And movement. I'll just go straight because if I turn, I'll kill myself. Don't want to do that. Very good. All right, we'll do Thrawn. Engineering. I'm going to use dial plus token. I'll raise 3, so do 1, 2, and 3. Alright, and then we'll start with the front to side.
Yep.
Alright, 2, 3, 5, 1, 2, 4. Yep, alright. I'll intensify one of, or not intensify, intel one of your braces.
Yep.
Confire in a blue. Come on, get the other one. Nope. All right, so 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 11.
MC 30, I will brace with the other. 2, 6.
Okay.
And I will redirect.
Sounds good.
Okay. Four to the front. And two to the side.
All right, and then we will gunnery teams under the front of this belt over here. We'll intensify, we'll stop your brace. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. No brace.
No brace and 10. I'm gonna discard my evade.
The doubles?
I'm doing doubles.
Yep. Alright. So 2, 8.
I will brace, and I will redirect.
I'll stop in your brace.
I will redirect.
Sorry. Yep.
Yep. So 8.
Yep.
So 1, 2, 2, and that's 4 to the hull.
Yep. With the crit. Yep. First one face up.
Shield failure. Mm-hmm. You may choose up to 2 hull zones. Each of those also releases 1 shield.
Yeah, you just have 1?
Yep.
Right here, and we'll ram and go back. All right, 2.
I'll take the filter with an engineering. I'll recover. He has 4 shields. I will send 2 shields and recover 1. Let's just try and shoot on the Cassanti. Front to side.
Mm-hmm.
Intensify.
And scatter.
Side to side. I'll leave it
there.
Remember
that? We'll try here. We'll do re-roll the red. Alright, and I'm just going to burn my scatter on that.
He's got 1 hull left, right?
Yeah, you're actually... Yeah, it didn't really matter. You're going to be able to ram and kill me.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. I just wanted to throw some dice.
Yep.
I'll go like this.
Yep. And boom. Very good.
I'm just going to go ahead and ram myself.
All right. My parts resupply.
Yep.
Navigate. Use it as a dial. Not in range to take a shot. But we will parts resupply. Send an engineering over. And speed up to speed 1. And we'll go forward straight one.
Well, when you move the rocks, you could not have moved the rocks under the ship. Therefore, because the ship's not moving, I can get possibly an entry.
I will do this tilt up. It has an engineering. So I will take one shield, which is the max.
No, it only matters where you went though.
And then I will cast two shields and recover one.
Sounds good.
I'm gonna go up to speed two.
Okay. I'll shoot. Not the front. On the ISB. Two rep. Intensify.
Nice. I'll redirect to my starboard side. Send them all over there.
I will do the side. Front.
Yep.
One.
I'll just take it. Actually, no, I take that back. I'm going to throw my one of my redirects, send it over here. And
I got this guy.
Yep.
That guy. Navigate, he'll drop to speed one.
All right, and then squad phase.
Is he in range still?
It's the plastic, I think, for this. Yep, so you're in range. Yep, you got it.
I should do it. Take a shot to the front. The ISD. For one.
Just take it.
Tiger will move. Okay.
All right, so refresh, and on to round five. You get two, I get one.
Are you just trying to be outside of Black Reef? I'm usually pretty liberal.
I will refresh my ECM.
Yep.
And refresh my parts resupply.
No. Yep. Round five, right?
If you want to
I will be intensifying. And a Thrawn dial, concentrate fire.
I will discard,
intensify, and shield to match this round.
They always get bummed. Could have been any worse than mine.
Uh-oh.
I'm
still hanging on by a thread. We'll see.
on the first move, I had to hit an asteroid trajectory to the line.
Yep.
There went the Providence shields.
Oh.
He has an engineering.
I hate that, getting that crit right at the beginning.
That's the worst. In the game at
yep.
the beginning.
And this thing has, he did was able to do the boarding troopers on this. Then hit me, he had me double arced, hit me, and then he was first player, and then hit me again, so it just obliterated the Kuat.
Quit doing mean stuff. Nice.
Yep.
I will discard one.
Yep.
And I will move one. He's gonna die anyway. Can you flip one on the front?
Oh, on the front, yes, of course. Yes. There we go.
Now I should have you in close range now.
Ah, I forgot to have you do Palpatine, but... Yeah. Oh, I don't have Palpatine. Never mind. I'm going crazy.
It's Sunday, man.
I only got close from my front. I think. Maybe not.
No.
Oh, you're talking about side?
Front.
Oh, front. Yeah, you got close. Oh. Yeah, because you can go closest point to closest point.
Yeah, but that's not an arc.
Oh, I see.
The arc is just past your...
Well, no, so you're in arc, and then you measure closest point to closest point of the arc you're in.
Yeah, but my arc... Only this part is in my arc.
Oh, that doesn't matter.
Yeah.
You're hitting my front arc, so you can hit my...
You've got a mission to the closest point that's within the arc, right? Actual arc.
I don't believe so. Let me check on that. I might have been doing this wrong.
Should we bother a Josh on it?
Yeah, that's a good question. I'll go find one. Oh. Hey, what's up, Mars? Judge! He's coming.
TRCs?
Yes. No. Okay. Because you spent it in that old defense.
Correct. Yes.
So I'm actually trying to prevent myself from using black eyes.
Prevent yourself from using black
eyes?
Yeah. Oh, so...
The front of the pelter to the front of the ISD. My arc ends just...
So it's the question is, once you measure the arc, then you do closest point after that, right? Or
yeah,
is it...
Within the arc that has been defined. Right?
Oh, gotcha.
Yeah,
okay,
so you
man.
Like, you can't cut across this line.
No. So I can measure to there, I gotta measure here.
Yeah, basically, if you look at where the line goes, you basically gotta go, okay, so the arc actually crosses around here.
And that's where you measure to... Oh, man, I've been doing that wrong for...
So
wow. Okay.
Can you take off the ISD
yes.
model?
Yes.
And hold that down. There we go.
You might also have him measure.
Yeah. Okay. Man, learning something new every day.
Yeah. So what we'll do is take this arc line, and you see how, like, looking at where it's going to cross your hull zone.
Right.
Now if I move this guy, like, we're at medium.
Okay.
You see that? Because that's where close is going to end right there. You agree with that?
Yeah, that was my goal.
But you don't measure from the edge of his... You just measure from the edge.
You do, but you're still going to match it, like, up with
where the arc is.
And so it's
right, gotcha.
Yeah.
But, man, okay. Wow, man, I've been doing that wrong since...
Let's play with your rules, then.
Right. No. Yeah. But, man, learn it.
Yeah.
Always learning something new. Man, well, for those watching... I've been doing that wrong my entire time doing the channel. Yep, two red into the front. Yes, for two. I will go ahead and spend my redirect. Redirect one and one.
And I will do the side.
Yeah.
Back front. 4-1.
And take it.
And he's going to bump.
Alright. Well, we will go with Thrawn. It's an engineering. Use it as a dial. So I'm going to move two from the back to the front and then raise one. And then we'll keep trying to hammer this thing front to side.
75?
75, yes. For the first shot. So... Five.
The last Thrawn, right?
Last Thrawn dial, yes.
Yep.
All right, so five reds, four blues. All right, I will intel one of your braces. Confire in a red. Intensify this. All right, and I am going to stop your non-intel brace with that one.
Yep.
2, 4, 6, 8. So that doesn't make it. So 9 doesn't make a difference. So we will then stop your redirect as well. So non-intel brace and redirect for 9.
For 9 to the side.
Yes.
So I will brace that down. Lift the brace. Brace it to 5.
Okay.
And I will contain. Take that.
Okay.
So that's two. Two hole.
Man, that's a tough ship. and then... Yes. Gunnery teams into the side of the Pelta.
Yeah.
And that'll do it. And then now for maneuvering, do you think that if I want to use my nav token? Yes, you got me now. That's not gonna save me. I don't think there's anything I can do. Actually, no, yeah, we will. Yeah. I need my nav token to be at speed 2. And we're gonna do this maneuver right here. So I'm gonna ram you at the 2.
Yeah.
And then go back to the 1.
And hope that Gazanti's just not in the way.
Yes, and hope that Gazanti isn't gonna stop me from doing this. Hey, and we are clear. Although I don't know if that saved me. I think we're still double arced, aren't we?
Yeah.
Ah, dang it.
But they ran.
Yep, but a ram. Dang.
Try. Yeah, so now I will activate the Pelta. He has an engineering. He's going to pass 2 sheets.
Well, it's now time to start praying to the dice gods. Yeah, parts resupply. To navigate. We will parts resupply an engineering token over. I will take it as a token and can't shoot because it's obstructed. I'll go in and flak Tycho just for the heck of it. Nothing. We'll con fire. Nothing. And then I'll ram myself.
I will activate the 2.
This is where I need the accuracy.
They have activated. He went down to 1. I will activate my flagship.
Yep.
Engineering.
Hey. Hey, hey, hey. I think I still got your side there.
Yeah. I will take 1 with shields to max to the side. I will move 1 shield from the rear to the front.
Okay.
And I will discard a damage card.
Okay.
I will shoot out the front.
Okay.
Your front.
Okay. You might actually have my side. Yeah, you got my side.
Let's do, you got my shield. Rear.
Yep.
Let's do side to side.
Or front to side. Yep. Mm-hmm. Come on, dice gods.
And intensify.
Oh, it's not going to matter. You're first player. Yeah, you're going to get me. 2, 4, 6, 7. Yeah.
Come on that side. Either side works.
Brace to 4. Burn my redirect. Contain.
Oh, wait a second. Wait a second. We're playing volatile deposits, right?
Oh, man, yeah. Same here. Man, I should have been doing that, too.
Damn. I was going to trigger this one.
Yep, so I'll do 1 additional.
That's 1 additional. Yep. That guy and that guy.
Dang it. I've been forgetting, too.
Just came with whoa, shit.
Yep, that was... I'll still spend my contain.
Yeah.
So, redirect 1... Oh, volatile deposits 1.
Yep.
And then
you brace the 4.
4, redirect 1, so I take 3 internal.
Yeah,
okay.
And yep. Then the Gosanti stuff is 1 as well.
What's that?
The Gosanti gets 1 as well.
Oh, yes, it does. I'll take it on the back. That's right. Man! We're getting volatile deposits.
Right the front. No blue crit. I will intensify this guy.
What speed are you going?
I'm going speed 2.
2?
And I'm just thinking about it. You know what? I'll just leave it as full damage.
Okay.
So what's 6 damage with a crit.
6 damage. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. What do I have up here?
You know what? You spent the brace once, right? I'll lock the brace. I'll lock the brace.
Lock the brace.
I'll lock the brace and do 5.
5 damage. 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 5. 1. I'm just gonna take it, not spend the brace. So.
Three for the hull.
Are you gonna do the specialty crit?
No, I need a blue.
Oh, yeah, that's right. You need a blue. Yep, and I'm not gonna contain.
You're not gonna contain.
No. So, first one face up.
Yep.
Disengage fire's control. Can't attack obstructed. To face down. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8.
I will do speed 2 straight ahead.
Yep, we'll ram. 2 health remaining.
Yeah. I think that's the squadron phase.
Yep.
I'll just roll 2.
Yep. And they got it. That'll do it. And then final points. I'm assuming they stopped. He's at 0.
Yeah, he moved.
And
down
he
to
moved,
one.
And he's still in range. That's right. So you'll get 2.
And you get 1.
I'll get 1. All right, and that'll be it. And I'll be honest. The reason why I let him die, I don't want you to keep farming.
Yeah.
Round 6.
But
ah, oh, man, that is a tanky. That's worse than a Starhawk.
Yeah, I really like.
Man, that is a tanky,
it
tanky.
11 damage. 10,
yeah.
9 damage.
12 damage was my first shot. I mean, it was, and you still were looking pretty fine, and still had a brace left.
Yeah.
Yeah, that was incredible. And then, of course, you know, I've had it happen to me before, but just every time that boarding engineers and then smacking me. Ugh.
And your name was.
Okay, well, that was a pretty brutal match. That boarding team combo is always brutal. I've had it happen to me a couple times, and I knew it was coming. I should have prepared better for it. But wow, that MC-75, holy cow, that thing was tough. With getting all the extra shields from the title and then the Peltas putting extra shields on it. And with all the defensive abilities it had, I mean, it just completely neutered my ability to put damage on it. And it didn't help that he was just able to drop the Kuat so fast. Overall, I'm actually, you know, overall my strategy I thought was fine, being in the corner next to the objectives, behind the dust fields. His little trick with Ezra, I was not expecting that. I was like, ah, man, when I saw it coming, I was like, I can't do anything to stop it. And then it really was the timing of my execution, I think, was my biggest flaw in this match, especially my use of the pass token. I should have waited one more turn to use the pass token. If I would have waited one more turn, I could have allowed the MC-75 to come into more of a kill box for me to hit him at, you know, to focus my fire more. I mean, I probably still lose and one of the ISDs, you know, like that, but it still allows me a chance to put more damage on it and maybe take the MC-75 out before I go down. But yeah, that was just a brutal list, just a brutal tank ability and devastating firepower with the boarding team combo cooking that off. So yeah, it was a good game. Got completely beat down, and but you know what? You know, again, today, this Sunday day that I was playing, was being more casual. Would have liked to perform better in this match, but man, I wasn't expecting how tough that MC75 was going to be. So that was the match. Thank you for the game. It was a lot of fun. And the next one coming up will be out in the next few days, Game 2 of the team's battle. So until next time, take it easy.